What is up, guys? It is So Canadian Gamer. We are back today, guys, with another Epic Spin Tires mod review. And today, guys, we're looking at the Land Cruiser BJ40 that recently came out over at ov.co.uk. This is a Hazard truck, so it's going to be fairly high quality. Usually, he makes some pretty awesome detailed stuff. And nonetheless, this thing looks amazing. I would definitely say this is one of his better mods that have come out as of recent. Credits to models go to SketchUp. The horn was done by Hazard and Brute. We're going to take a look at the horn in a second. Suspension and animation was done by Powers 2440 and Overheating Slacker. The wheels were done by SID and Hazard. There is two different sets of wheels. We'll take a look at those in a second. And everything else was done by Jeep Cherokee 94, Powers, and Captain Blue for the testing. And all the rest of the textures were done by Hazard. We will take a look at the wheels, though. So we have the default wheels, which are currently equipped. And honestly, they look pretty good to me. They look very nostalgic, authentic to what this truck might have had. And then we have the SID K5 Blazer wheels, which are more of a custom look if that's what you're going to go for. Depending on the skin that you choose, I've chosen the black and yellow skin. There's also a gray and blue skin or gray and black skin included. And then the default skin is just pure black. I'm going to go with the default tires, though. I think those look the best. We do have the epic horn, which the South will rise again. That thing sounds awesome. I could do that all day. I'm not going to, though, because that'll annoy you. We will get it on, guys. Of course, the links are down below in the description for the truck and the map. We're playing on Blackwater High Desert. We also have a really epic interior view, which is super detailed. Tons of features added into this. I'm guaranteeing that if you were to go look up Google Images on the interior of this truck, this is probably 100% accurate. As I've said in the past, all we're really missing is a working steering wheel and a gear shifter, and we have a full-on off-roading simulator, which is pretty awesome when you consider the fact that this has been done by modders and guys on their own time. None of this has been done by the developers of OV, and it's still really high quality stuff. So just fantastic community around Spin Tires. As always, guys, if you'd like to see more of these videos, hit that subscribe button and hit that like button. I do appreciate it very much. I am trying to hit 1,000 subscribers, which is a pretty realistic goal, I think, for YouTube in this day and age. So if you guys could help me reach that goal, I would very much appreciate it. We're gonna have to be careful going through this section. The truck does have 250 damage points and 250 liters of fuel, so equal in that. But it doesn't use a lot of fuel from what I'm seeing, like 4 liters, and we're in automatic, kind of just gassing it. And at the max, it uses like under 10 liters. And we have diff lock and all wheels on, of course. I'm going to try and throw it into high gear, but not like that. There's some really epic mud over this hill, so I'm going to see how the truck gets it on through there. I'm really curious to see what the dangerous water level on this is going to be. We'll have a look-see. Not too bad. We haven't taken damage yet. Interesting. I would say that's not the most realistic dangerous water level. We've pretty much submerged the whole truck. Now, if it did have a snorkel on it, that would definitely be realistic, but otherwise, I mean, it is still a really awesome truck. Tons and tons of detail, and I'm really liking the low gear and the low range in this truck. It seems to have a good balance of traction and a decent speed. Sometimes you see low crawling gears that are just too low and you're constantly switching gears, which I guess is realistic, but not that good of an experience in Spin Tires, to be honest with you. Great reflection that comes off the windows as well. Of course, the back windows in this truck, from my understanding, are pretty expensive to replace because they are curved glass, which of course is always going to be expensive. Oh, we really have to watch going through here. Oh geez. Very sketchy, tipsy truck. It feels like it's on the verge of flipping all the time, and that's induced by its narrow footprint, but also it's notoriously known for being a very top-heavy truck. They did manufacture this all the way up till 2001 in Brazil. However, they did stop in 1984, I think, 85, around there, in all other countries. This being the BJ version, it is going to be a diesel. Only ranged from around 80 to 100 horsepower, depending on the year you got, and had about 110 to 130 foot-pounds of torque, which isn't a lot, but it really is enough to get the job done for a lightweight vehicle like this. You're not going to be doing intense hauling. You're not going to be doing logs or anything with this truck. It really is a good scout vehicle and seems like a good replacement for the UAZ. Don't get me wrong, I like the UAZ, but it's kind of crappy, to be honest with you, and this would be a good a really, really good replacement for that. So far, I'm liking the crawling gear in this truck. It just feels authentic. I'm gonna try and go through these courses and these routes a little bit, oh God, a little bit slower. One of my viewers called me out and said that I drive a little bit too fast. And to be honest with you, I agree 100% with him. I do drive too fast sometimes through these sections. And I'm gonna try and go a little bit slower and pick our lines and just be careful. Try and take a lot less damage than I do in most of my reviews. This is a very tricky corner. In order to get around this corner efficiently, you have to avoid getting stuck in the rut that we're getting stuck in right now. It's very easy to roll the truck and stall it as we're doing right there. Okay, we'll throw it into reverse and try and get out of here. Unfortunately, there isn't very many winch points through this area too, so if you do roll it over, you're kinda in the water with no paddle, which is unfortunate. Throw it back into low gear and try and crawl through this area. I found that the best way to attack this little area is if you can just go over the rut, really. You don't want to get in that rut because it is just all bad. Oh geez. Very bouncy truck. Great animation though, I gotta say, just fantastic animation. If we do roll it going through here, we're gonna continue on, oh God, to the barrels of death. And just by turning the wheels back and forth, you can kind of roll it back onto its four wheels, which, because it has such a short wheelbase, you're gonna be able to do that. Is there anything I can winch to? There's gotta be something. Yeah, see, there's just nothing I can winch to. It's one of, this section is so tricky. We'll throw it back into reverse, and maybe we can, oh man, this is so hard. If I could just, honestly, if the truck had a little bit longer wheelbase, it would be better. Truck did come in, oh God, we're gonna roll it. I don't think we're gonna be able to make it through this area. Not because of the truck's inability, just really, I mean, a combination of my driving and just this section. This section, really only long vehicles with a lot of ground clearance really do well through that area. If there's a way I could skip over that, that would be awesome. Should I just go for it? I'm just gonna go for it. We're probably gonna roll it over. Power! Power! Not, doesn't have a lot of power, but still. Power! And we just beasted that section. What an awesome truck. That short wheelbase really helped us out in that area. I'd like to use the interior view because it is so nice. I like that the interior view is kinda in the middle. Like, if you take a look, the interior view, it's not on the left-hand side, which is weird, but it's typically the default position is in the middle of the truck, which I kind of like, especially because you're not able to look around in real time, like virtual reality or anything like that. Kind of nice to have it in the middle. You get the best field of vision, I find. So far, there isn't any lack of traction, though, with this vehicle. It really does have a ton of traction. Really, my only complaint is it's a little bit unstable, as you're seeing right now. Going through these sections at a higher rate of speed is honestly better for this truck. Maybe if we try and take the left side or right side of this, we'll have better luck. We'll just kind of beast through this area. It does have some pretty cool lights. We'll take a look at those. Would be nice to see like a light bar or some extra add-ons. From my understanding, I was doing some reading and research, and Spun in Darkness, other mod authors, they're starting to not put as many add-ons with their trucks, and for a good reason. They kind of mess up the physics. Makes the truck handle a little bit different. It sinks in mud quicker. It takes more damage, and it kind of just screws around with the truck, and it puts all the hard work that the authors do, and it just kind of messes around with it. And I can see that. At the same time, though, I love to have add-ons. It adds more personality to the truck and really lets you customize it to your liking. Plus, the extra repair points and fuel is always a nice touch to have. But if it's going to ruin the experience in the truck, I can totally understand why they don't include add-ons. Would it be nice to see some different variants of this truck? I know SID came out with the FJ40 from quite a long time ago. I like to say quite a long time ago. I think it was last year, which isn't that long ago. In the Spin Tires world, though, in the modding community, that's a pretty long time. And that was a fantastic crawling truck. You could pretty much crawl anything in spin tires that you desired. I'm surprised to not see a spare tire on the back. I would have expected that out of this truck. I think it would have been a nice little touch. There could have been a spare tire on the back and it might have been taken off just because it dragged on the ground and took too much damage. That's my guess. Nevertheless though, just a really fantastic truck. I'm liking the feeling of it. It feels realistic. The animation's fantastic. And the level of detail is just, I mean, some of these authors, the amount of detail that they put in this stuff is just mind-blowing. It really is. You feel like you're driving the real truck, or you have that feeling that it was put into the game by a Spinterra's developer. I have to be a little bit careful around this section here. So far, I've been rolling with all wheels and diff lock on the entire time. Our turning radius is pretty atrocious, I must say, but that is going to give us the most traction. I don't know if I want to risk going through here without diff lock. We might have to here, though. I'll try it out. We'll take diff lock off, and of course, we're going to get a much tighter turning radius, but we're going to lose all of our grip. And as you can see, we've lost all of our grip. Maybe I can get out of here. Jimmy my way out of here. There we go. Good to go, good to go. And that short wheelbase is just awesome for going through stuff like this. Yeah, I think I might have to turn the diff lock back on. If I could see an all-wheel drive system like I seen on the MAN Cat that I did a review on not too long ago, that would be epic. The all-wheel drive system on that thing was just on another level. I couldn't believe the fact that you could roll through entire sections without having to turn the diff lock on once. Ooh, I'm gonna have to be careful through here. Try and go at a little bit faster pace. I find with these type of trucks, when you go slower, it's actually worse. I must apologize if you guys hear stuff in the background. It is peak hours in my household. I'll try and edit out as much as I can, but you might hear somebody talking in the background or such. It's just one of the royalties of living with people, and it's just nothing I can avoid. So sorry if you do hear that. Oh God, that is a epic rut of death. Clawing away for traction, still in low gear. Haven't really had an opportunity to test out the high gear too much, and I'd like to do that. There we go. Kind of contradicting myself. I said I was going to go slow through these sections, but I'm impatient. And as long as we don't take damage, I don't see the problem with it, really. I mean, we are going to go hit up the barrels of death, which of course we're going to go slow through there, and we'll get a chance to see some of the crawling capabilities. I really do like to do that at the end of the video, though, because it's pretty easy to wreck your truck very quickly going through there. Really just an awesome, fantastic scouting vehicle, though. And we have some mud here, and I'm a little bit worried. Oh God, I'm a little bit worried about this mud because I have froze up going through this mud before. I'm not going to go the other way. It's really weird. I don't know what it is with that mud, but my game seems to like to freeze. It likes to freeze in that area over there. At dangerous water level, it just doesn't seem realistic. If the truck had a snorkel, I'd buy into it, but the fact that you can submerge pretty much the whole thing underwater and really take no damage, maybe that needs a little bit of tweaking. Get a chance to see some of the rock crawling. And I'll actually throw it into low gear. There we go. Go into low gear. Yes. You can do it. And we'll see how much traction we can carry over all of this. That truck just looks so fantastic. I gotta say, it really is a really, really awesome mod. I would recommend it. Just because it's a legendary Land Cruiser, a lot like the Land Rover. It is just a legendary truck in the off-roading world. Any situation you get the truck into, you're going to be able to fix it. It's a very simple vehicle, which is why it is notoriously known as a great off-roading vehicle. It's because it is so simple, very easy to fix, has probably the most simple electrical system you'll ever see in a vehicle. Doesn't have any doodads or anything crazy. I think they had a power steering version of this truck that came out in the 80s or the late 80s. But this looks like an older Land Cruiser. Probably didn't have that. None of those luxuries, but you really don't need it. You don't need luxuries. You don't need air conditioning. Go into high gear and go through this water crossing. It is a light vehicle. Could struggle in water crossings. The water could wash you away down the river, which would be terrible. I was expecting the truck to take a lot more damage when over those rocks, though. And I would say that Hazard has done a good job with the damaging balance on the truck. I don't know if that's a thing. I'm going to call it that, though. Throw it back in a high gear for this hill up here. Take a look at that interior view again. It really, again, just looks amazing. Absolutely amazing interior view. Tons and tons of detail. I love it. Get out of that view and we'll take on this beast of a hill. Not too much of a problem for this truck. 25 damage though. I probably should, oh god. Whoa, we didn't roll it. I think we're gonna roll it though. I don't know how to get out of this. Can I winch? Oh, if I can winch. Yes, there's a tree. Winch it back over and we are alive again. There we go. We will throw it into low gear. Oh geez, this is really sketchy stuff right here. I just don't want to roll it. There we go. There we go. You do have to be careful with the truck. Pick your lines. You can't carelessly drive. Oh god. Like I just did. Oh my god. What happened? I think it just endoed over itself. I wasn't really going that fast either. I mean, I was putting down the hill. Interesting. Well, what we'll do... That truck pretty much beasted that section anyways. We'll go back, we'll hit up the barrels of death and see how the truck gets it on through this section. So far from what I've seen from the truck, I think it's going to beast this section. You never know though, you never know though. The Achilles heel could be the barrels of death. High gear is probably going to be our best bet going through this section. You really need that momentum. We'll keep the diff lock on, we've taken a little bit of damage. Can I beast over these barrels? Get some grip? Yes. It's those barrels, those first, the ending row of barrels before that little hill. If you can get over that, you're good to go. You're good to go for pretty much the rest of it. Try and go a little bit slower through here. I'm finding though with the vehicle, the faster you go, the better off you are, kind of. I don't know. It's a very weird feeling vehicle. It has a weird bounce to it. If you go too fast, it'll bounce out of control. You go too slow, it's very unstable. You kind of just have to go through at the right speed, which is a challenge. It is a challenge. I like that though. Not complaining. It is a great, great mod. Ooh, that is a rut right there. If I can get around that, we'll be good. And tons of grip. Awesome rock crawler from what I've seen so far. And not having too many issues through any of this. I'm not surprised that it did well. I was expecting it to take a lot more damage though. And be honestly more top heavy. I mean, it is a tipsy vehicle by nature. But I was expecting it to be worse than it was through that section we went through. So I'm actually very impressed with the mod. I would recommend downloading it. Give it a try, guys. There is some extra skins included with it. Maybe try out the other wheels. They could have higher levels of grip. Oh god. Throw it back in a reverse here. And these barrels are probably going to destroy half of our vehicle going through this section. We only have 250 damage points. I would like to see maybe like 400 damage points. Just to be safe. Maybe a little bit extra fuel. So you could really actually scout a whole map. That would be cool. Oh, geez, rolled it again, and again we rolled it. Interesting, and see, I wasn't even going that, and I just lightly feathered on the brake, and it just endowed over itself. That is so weird. Well, we made it through most of it. That is the whole area that we covered, guys, which is a good portion of the map, and we didn't have too many failures. I'm sure if I went a little bit slower through these sections, maybe we could have made it through. We did have to winch a couple times. Really fantastic vehicle. I'm going to end the review there, guys. Thank you so much for checking it out. As always, the links are down below in this description if you'd like to download the truck and the map and try it out for yourself. Of course, hit that like button and the subscribe button if you'd like to see more of these epic Spintires videos. I am trying to hit 1,000 subscribers. If you guys could help me reach that goal, I would very much appreciate it. Anyways, guys, it's been good. Peace.